The Atlantic salmon is the only species of salmon found in the Atlantic Ocean. Like their Pacific cousins, these fish are born in freshwater rivers, embark on extensive feeding migrations in the open ocean, and return years later to reproduce in the same rivers from which they came. Unlike the Pacific species, which die after spawning, Atlantic salmon can migrate between fresh and salt water and reproduce multiple times. In the U.S., we eat a lot of salmon, and if it's Atlantic salmon, it's farmed. Once known as the king of fish, wild salmon historically filled our northeast rivers as far south as Long Island Sound. Today, adults migrate into just a few rivers and streams in Maine, where fewer than 2,000 return annually, barely 1% of the historic population. Maine's largest watershed, the Penobscot River, has gained priority status as one of NOAA's habitat focus areas, which brings many partners together to help recover this highly endangered species.
The Gulf of Maine Atlantic salmon population was listed as an endangered species back in 2000, and Maine really offers the last best hope for their recovery. The troubles for salmon really began shortly after the Europeans settled this land a long time ago. As our populations grew, we exploited these rivers for their abundant fisheries, used them as highways for transporting logs, and constructed dams to power mills and eventually generate electricity. Today, over 400 dams block or impede the ability of Atlantic salmon to access over 90% of their historical habitat.
Atlantic salmon are also commercially fished in international waters, and warming ocean temperatures may be affecting the food webs they depend on.
But all is not lost. We do have hope that this population can actually recover. NOAA's Species in the Spotlight is just the latest initiative to do everything possible to turn things around for Atlantic salmon. For instance, we're working with many partners to improve access to quality habitats by removing dams when possible, replacing undersized road culverts, and installing highly effective fishways when dam removal is not an option. Since Atlantic salmon were listed, more than 17 dams have been removed from rivers in Maine where Atlantic salmon live.
Removing these 17 dams has improved access to more than 1,000 river miles of habitat. Steps like these pave the road to recovery for not only Atlantic salmon, but other sea-run fish as well, like river herring, American shad, and American eel. At dams that aren't coming down, new or redesigned fishways improve passage for these fish coming upriver. At some, viewing windows yield accurate counts of returning fish, and the opportunity to collect and study adult salmon. Many will be taken to hatcheries, spawned, and the offspring released into the Penobscot watershed the following spring.
This program is really a critical tool in preventing the extinction of Atlantic salmon while their populations are at critically low levels, and it buys us time while we work to restore their habitats. Due to the endangered status of Atlantic salmon, it is illegal to fish for them in U.S. waters. In international waters, NOAA is working with partners to reduce the harvest of U.S. origin salmon to zero. We are also researching how changing marine conditions are affecting salmon survival and ways to lessen its impacts. As for what you can do, there are many ways that you can help restore our rivers and streams. You could work with your local communities to remove dams that are no longer being used. You could help replace culverts that are not fish-friendly with fish-friendly culverts and bridges. Also, if you live near a river or stream, you can plant a well-forested buffer around the river or stream. This provides shade for the fish, provides food, and helps keep the water cool.
Together, we can bring the Atlantic salmon back from the brink of extinction in the U.S. and save a piece of our culture. Atlantic salmon can thrive in our rivers and streams, and maybe one day, we can again line the banks of our northeast rivers with hopes of catching the king of fish.